Daryl, how are you?
Doing good. How are you?
Yeah, really glad that you came in.
Well, man, thanks for having me.
I want to play a few of Daryl's number ones real quick. This is from 2002, I Miss My Friend.
I miss my friend. The one my heart.
From 2003, here is Have You Forgotten.
Have you forgotten how it felt that day?
And 2004, here is Awful Beautiful Life.
My little brother had a big fight with his wife, and my poor mother sat between them both all night. I love this crazy tragic, sometimes almost magic, awful beautiful life.
That's a jam. I haven't heard that one in a while, man. I missed that one. Well,
it still gets a lot of airplay. It's a cool song.
I think the last time I heard that was in like a Kroger or something, and I was like, because sometimes you hear songs. Because for me, 2004, I was in college. Sometimes you hear songs that remind you of like a certain
sure.
time,
absolutely.
And that one for sure does.
Awesome.
You're actually here because tomorrow is the 20th anniversary of 9/11, and when I think about, and I just did a big special with Circle Network and the Opry on the music of 9/11, which is going to air on Circle Network tomorrow. It's a big 2-hour special.
I'm on that too.
Yeah, no, I know. It's part of the reason that we wanted to get you in here.
Oh, cool.
Because we were talking about a lot of the songs and, you know, how it affected us in many different ways. And, you know, whenever you put out a song about 9/11, you know, it's really one of those songs that really reminds me of that time. Like, I can remember vividly whenever it happened. You know, I went to college in Arkansas at a really small school called Henderson State University. And we all went to the student union, and it started like two people looking up at a screen in the corner. Then it was four. And then before, you know, the next 20 or 30 minutes went by, it was 40 rows deep of people going, what in the world is happening? We had no idea what was happening.
Sure.
And kind of as the events played out, it took music to kind of get us back to a somewhat normal place again.
Right.
Because for a long time, we didn't know if we could sing. We didn't know if we could laugh.
Right.
You know, we didn't know a lot of stuff, but when we were talking about songs to talk about in this, you know, obviously you came up and, you know, Have You Forgotten, you know, was one of those songs for us. So talk about this. You go into a writing room, and did you have in mind to write a song about 9/11 specifically, or did it just kind of come up in conversation?
No, I had just returned from my first journey to Afghanistan to entertain our troops, and I told my manager on the way home that I just felt very compelled to do something to honor, you know, people like our first responders. We lost a lot of guys that day that were trying to save other people's lives. Obviously, we lost a lot of citizens. And then we lost a ton of our good military men and women in the war zone, you know, putting the heat on the terrorist. And so I just wanted to write a song that would honor all those people and their families and you know, for the loss. And so, yeah, we sat down with intentions of writing the song, but we didn't have intentions of you know, trying to get it on the radio or anything like that. I told Wynn, my co-writer, I said, this is something that we could definitely use to, you know, on my return journeys to the war zone, I can play it. You know, I can play it for when I do special things with police departments or fire departments, and it'll be a well-received thing. But I had a single on the radio that was doing very well, and I had a brand new album out, and so we weren't looking to disrupt all that. It was just a song we wanted to write.
You know, the wild part about it is that it takes sometimes 20, 30, 40 weeks for a song to get to the top of the charts. But this song impacted so fast. First of all, it was number one for 7 weeks, but it only took 5 weeks to get there.
Right.
Like people, it just shook people.
Yep.
Because of the message and how you sing it. And so we wanted to bring you in today, with tomorrow being that anniversary of 9/11, and just ask if you'd mind playing Have You Forgotten for us.
Not at all.
You still play this one a lot?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. This year's been unusual because coming out of COVID, you know, we didn't expect things to just explode, but it's almost like we have re-released the song, and because of the 20th anniversary, it's just been wide open. So I'm not complaining in any way.
Your latest album too, I want to talk about this because, you know, you're about making a difference, and so 22, will you talk about the importance of that record?
Well, you know, I'll be honest with you, Bobby. It blows my mind every day I talk to someone, because we're kind of in that mindset right now, that doesn't know that we have 22 service members, men or women, taking their own life every day in this nation. And, you know, because of what they've been through, because of their PTSD, because of whatever situation it is, that to me doesn't matter. We as a nation should be taking care of those people. And so, our government doesn't seem to be really, really active in that. So Charlie Daniels pulled me aside about a month or two before he passed away, and he said, "Son, this stuff's going to be up to us. It's going to have to come from, you know, a different place, maybe the private sector or whatever. But we need to get busy at this work, because these people are suffering, and they've given more to this nation and more to its people than anybody that I can think of. So, you know, what do we owe them? Well, we owe them whatever we can do to help them." And so 22 is that. 22 is the title cut. We have a song out off of that right now called Send Me. And our plan is to kind of release everything from the project between now and Veterans Day. And just to make people aware of it. And hopefully we can, you know, get some streams and downloads and sell some of that product. And we're going to give proceeds to some different charitable organizations that will make a difference in that area.
You can also order some of Daryl's 9/11 Have You Forgotten Leatherwood Whiskey coming out, that's raising money for military charities, DarylWorley.com. I've never had a drink of alcohol. What's the difference between bourbon and whiskey in taste?
Well, bourbon is a whiskey, or yeah. Some people would say that's not true. So let's talk about the difference between bourbon and rye. They're made from different things. And the bourbon is a little more... It's just a little smoother. Rye whiskey has a little bit more of an edge to it.
So if I were going to have a first drink, I'd probably go bourbon before whiskey, because it's smoother.
Some people would say you probably ought to get you a slow gin fizz or a vodka drink first. But yeah, I would say drink the bourbon first.
I'd probably go pina colada.
Let's be real.
Now, there's a great idea.
Well, you guys, check out 22. Follow Daryl at Daryl Worley on Instagram, and we just appreciate you coming in.
Man, can I say this before
I go? You can say whatever you want.
I feel like I'm on American Idol, and I'm too old. There's no way.
Why do you feel like you're on American Idol? You're killing it right now.
I'm just killing. I'm kidding.
Well, you know what?
Kidding with you.
You win.
Man.
He's our next American Idol. You just won American Idol.
I told him. I said, I've been watching him on the show so much, and my wife's like, "You're not going in to sit down with him." I said, "Well, yes, I am."
Well, listen, we felt the same way about you. We're like, "Oh, he's coming in." We're like, "Yeah."
So it's great seeing you.
Well, listen,
thank you.
Been a big fan for a long time.
Thank you, sir.
We appreciate it. We know tomorrow is the anniversary, yeah. But we're not on the air tomorrow.
Right.
So we definitely wanted to treat today as much as we could like that. So thank you for your time.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you for writing that song and for all that you
yes,
do.
Yes, sir.
There he is, Daryl Worley, everybody. Woo-hoo! This is a Bobby Bones show.